I'm Ty.
And I'm Kathrin.
And this is Ask the Expert. So we have a question that asks, why am I getting brittleness when I cast Platinum Rune 950? What can be done to avoid these issues?
Well, first of all, platinum ruthenium is more demanding to cast just because the melting temperatures are much higher and the fluidity is lower. So that means you have to apply extremely meticulous process steps to control what you're casting, and it requires experience and attention to detail. But if you're asking me what are the two key things that cause brittleness in the platinum alloy, then I would say first, it's metal contamination, and second, it is the wrong melting technology. For instance, like torch melting, yes.
So does that mean torch melting should not be used?
Yes, absolutely, it should not be used. There are two very good reasons. The first one is platinum ruthenium is toxic, so when you're melting it, you should wear a respirator and you should wear melting goggles, and the combination of these two pieces of personal protection equipment is extremely uncomfortable. But the second reason is that when you are melting platinum ruthenium in the atmosphere at such high temperatures, the chances that you trap oxygen into the melt are very high, and you have automatically contamination, which is exactly the thing that you want to avoid.
So you mentioned platinum rue is not very fluid, but does fluidity have an impact on brittleness?
Yes, absolutely. Platinum ruthenium requires much higher casting temperatures, and the probability of achieving shrinkage porosity are higher. So that's a structural strength issue. You have holes in the material, and so this is of course causing brittleness. But there are a host of other reasons why you could have a brittleness in platinum ruthenium. And that is, for instance, the sprue design, the tree design, the casting temperatures, the casting equipment, and operational issues. So all this can majorly contribute to brittleness in platinum ruthenium.
So are there any other known causes that creates brittleness in the metal?
Yes, absolutely. So there's a whole host of reasons how platinum can get contaminated. One of them could be recast platinum alloys. It could be steel tools that come close to the melting setup. It could be investment materials that are not suitable for the platinum platinum process. It could be wrong gas type or torch type. It could be wrong soldering boards or refractory materials. Or it could be graphic silica or carbon that come in touch with the melted platinum. And lastly, overused crucibles could be a real problem.
That's a lot to take in. We'll cover them in future episodes. You've asked the expert, and the expert has spoken.